WTTW, in association with Marshall Field & Company, presents The Storyteller.
I dwell among the heroes of your favorite stories. Come, share with me the adventures of reading. My friends, welcome once more to the bookshelves of the Storyteller. Would you like to be a private eye? You know what a private eye is? A detective. Well, then listen to the story of some boys who wanted to be private eyes. Our title is The Case of the Cats Meow, written by Crosby Bonsall and published by the Harper and Row. What, I wonder, has a cat's meow got to do with private eyes? Well, let's find out, shall we? Our story goes like this. Snitch was yelling. He was pulling a wagon with a funny thing in it. And he was yelling. Stop yelling, yelled his brother, Wizard. Stop yelling, yelled his friend, Skinny. Stop yelling, yelled his friend, Tubby. Snitch stopped yelling, and it was very quiet. The little noise in the wagon sounded like a loud cry. Meow! There, in an old birdcage, sat Mildred. Mildred was Snitch's cat. I'm keeping her safe, Snitch said. Somebody might steal her. Who wants old Mildred? Tubby said. She's dumb. She's no fun, Skinny said. She makes too much noise, Wizard said. She's nice, Snitch yelled. I love Mildred. Nobody is going to steal Mildred, Wizard said. We are private eyes. We have our own clubhouse. We have a sign on the door. Nobody will steal anything. Take my word for it. We can catch anybody now, Tubby said. We have an alarm. What alarm? Snitch asked. The alarm we just put in, Skinny said. Step over this string. See? Wizard said. If anybody comes sneaking around here, he'll trip over this string. That will pull this pail of water down on his head, and then the string on the pail handle will ring this bell, and it'll ring and ring and ring. Snitch said, and we'll catch whoever wants to steal Mildred. Nobody wants to steal Mildred, Wizard said. Take my word for it. Snitch started to yell. Come on, said Wizard. It's almost time for supper.
I knew it must be, Tubby said. They stepped over the string. Nobody wanted to set off the alarm.
When Snitch and Wizard got home, Mildred ran up the back steps. She ran in the little door, in the big door, that was her door.
She's nice, Snitch said. I love Mildred.
But did Mildred love Snitch? The next morning she didn't come when Snitch called her.
He called and he called and he called.
Wizard looked out the window.
Somebody stole Mildred,
Snitch yelled. Nobody stole Mildred, Wizard said. Take my word for it.
But he came down in a hurry.
I'll call Skinny and Tubby, Wizard said. They'll help us find Mildred.
Somebody stole her,
Snitch said, and he started to yell. The boys looked for Mildred all that day.
Anybody seen a dumb cat?
Tubby asked.
Anybody seen a cat?
Skinny asked.
She doesn't do much.
Anybody seen a noisy cat? Wizard asked.
Have you seen my cat, Mildred?
Snitch asked.
She's soft, and she's nice, and I love her.
But he didn't find Mildred.
Nobody found Mildred. Nobody had even seen Mildred. Back at the clubhouse, Wizard said, "We're not very good private eyes if we can't find Mildred."
"But how can we?"
Skinny asked.
"Food,"
Tubby said. "Mildred has to eat."
"Hey, that's a good idea," said Wizard. "Tonight we'll put food in the yard. If Mildred is hungry, she'll come home."
"She likes liver,"
Snitch said,
"and strawberry jelly without seeds."
"I like strawberry jelly," Tubby said. Each of the boys brought some food. Next day, they had cats, all right. They had cats in the tree, cats on the roof. They had cats on the grass, and one cat sitting on a stone in the middle of the brook, but no Mildred.
"Our plan was no good," Wizard said. "How do we get rid of these cats?"
"I know," Skinny cried. "Dogs. Dogs will chase the cats away."
"They'll scare Mildred," Snitch said.
"Mildred isn't here," Wizard said. Snitch started to yell again. Well, the boys brought every dog they could find on the block. They got rid of the cats, all right. But now they had dogs. They had dogs in the tree, dogs on the roof. They had dogs on the grass, and one dog sitting on a stone in the middle of the brook. And it took the rest of the day to take the dogs home. After supper, Wizard called a meeting. "We have to keep our eyes open day and night," he said. "Let's ask if we can sleep in the yard tonight." They went to bed, even before their bedtime. They liked being outdoors. It was warm, and the sky was full of stars. And soon each of them was sound asleep. And that was when the alarm went off. The bell rang and rang. Wizard was up first, then Skinny. Tubby got stuck in his sleeping bag, so he took it with him. Wizard turned on his flashlight.
There was Snitch. I heard someone stealing Mildred," he said.
"You can't steal a cat who's not here," Wizard yelled. But they all went into the house for the rest of the night. And next day, Snitch told them something.
"Last night, I put food in Mildred's dish, and now it's gone."
Wizard was mad because he hadn't thought of Mildred's dish. But he had a plan. That night, he put Mildred's dish on a cookie tin filled with flour. Whoever's eating the food will have to walk over the flour, and the white feet will leave a trail that we can follow. Next morning, the food was gone. But there were clear white paw prints going down the steps. And then the paw prints stopped.
"Oh, shucks," Tubby cried. "The flour didn't last long enough."
And Snitch started to yell.
"What'll we do now?"
Skinny asked. "Try again tonight," Wizard said. "And we'll lock Mildred's door."
"Why?"
asked Tubby. "That cat is so noisy," Wizard said. "She'll cry if she can't get in."
"And we'll hear her,"
Tubby said,
"and the case will be solved. Then we'll be private ears," Skinny said.
That night, the boys met on the porch.
"Now let's keep our eyes open," Wizard said.
And they went to bed early. But the night was warm, the sky was full of stars, and soon they were sound asleep.
"What was that?"
Tubby whispered.
"Oh, just an old cat,"
Snitch said, and he started to go back to sleep.
"A cat,"
he shouted.
"It's Mildred. She's found."
Wizard turned on his flashlight.
And it was Mildred, all right, but she was going away.
"Meow,"
she said as she left.
"Follow that cat," Wizard yelled. And down the steps they ran, over the grass, up to the clubhouse. Mildred was one jump ahead of them. One more jump took her over the string.
The string that was part of the alarm.
"Some alarm," Wizard said. "It sure doesn't catch cats."
Each boy stepped over the string. Mildred jumped into the basket in the corner.
"Where's Mildred?"
cried Snitch.
"I brought her supper."
"The case is solved," said Wizard. "I told you nobody stole her."
Snitch ran over to the basket. He started to yell again. Mildred has kittens! Oh, boy, I want one, Tubby cried. Me too, said Skinny. Don't forget me, Wizard said. But Snitch had his arms around the basket. Tubby said Mildred was dumb, Snitch said. Skinny said she was no fun. Wizard said she made too much noise. Well, they had said all those things, and right then they changed their minds. Mildred was nice. They loved her, and so they waited for the kittens to grow old enough to leave their mother. And when they were old enough, Snitch gave a kitten to each private eye. Well, this is one case I'm glad we solved, Skinny said. It's lucky, said Tubby. We're such good private eyes. The alarm didn't help us. Snitch was the only one we ever caught with it, Wizard said. Mildred will take care of us now, Snitch said. No, my cat will, said Tubby. No, my cat will, said Skinny. No, my cat will, said Wizard. You can take my word for it. And Snitch was yelling again. And Snitch was yelling again. Do you like that story? I did too. Yes, it's fun to read stories, isn't it? Have you ever tried to be a detective, Private Eye? Say, you know what I'd wish you'd do? I wish you'd write and tell me whether you have or not. I wish you'd write and tell me whether or not you like the story tonight or whether or not you like any of my stories. You could tell me those you like the most, those you didn't like at all. I hope there weren't any like that, but there might have been. And you might also like to draw a picture, like you have before. Some of you have drawn some lovely pictures of me. I've kept them. Some of you have drawn pictures of some of the characters in our stories. I wish you would do that again. Because, you see, well, my friends have taken another picture of me. And I'd like to send that so that you could add it to your collection that you have of the Storyteller. And then we could share our feelings about books, why you like stories, which ones you like, and I find out that way whether or not you like them. So when you write to me, write to the Storyteller. Be sure and address it to the Storyteller, Channel 11, WTTW, Box 1100, Chicago, Illinois, 60690. Once again, the Storyteller, WTTW, Channel 11, Box 1100, Chicago, Illinois, 60690. Right. And then, I think that's all the time we have. We'll talk again some more about all this, won't we? And now, my friends, until we meet again, may your hours be filled with the adventures of reading.
Storyteller is made possible by a grant from Marshall Field & Company. Books used on the program are provided by the Book Department of Marshall Field & Company.